Now let's look at inheritance and polymorphism in Python. And before I do that, I just want to clean up my pseudocode a little bit. So I noticed when I was editing the previous video that I forgot to declare these methods and functions as public. So the constructor is public, and the accessors and mutators are public. And this display method is public, and I also forgot to add the end module here. So now our pseudocode looks a little better than it did before. And now we can go ahead and declare some subclasses. So we have an animal class, and this is for all different kinds of animals. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to get rid of this type parameter in the constructor, and instead I'm just going to set the type to animal. So when I create a new animal object, it's just the generic animal and I can't specify what type it is. And if I say get type, it's just going to return animal. And I'm going to get rid of this setter too, so there's no way for the user to set the type. So let me go ahead and do that up in the pseudocode as well. I'm going to initialize this to animal. And I'm going to get rid of type in the constructor. And I'm going to get rid of the setter for type. So if I run the code now, I need to get rid of these types. So canary is gone, dog is gone, cat is gone. And if I run it, I get back almost the same results, but now it just says an animal named Tweety, an animal named Rover, an animal named Simba. So what if I want to create a dog object? Well, I can create a subclass of animal that inherits all of the properties and methods of animal, but then I can specify things that make dogs different from animals. So one thing that might make a dog different from just a regular animal is its type. So let's make a new class, dog extends animal. So a dog is a type of animal. And the difference is that it has the type is dog. And then right now everything else is going to be the same. So let's write this class. And the way I show inheritance in pseudocode is I say extends the parent class. In Python, that's what I put in the parentheses. So dog, open paren animal, says that dog is a type of animal. And then I can specify under type is equal to dog here. So now if I go in and change Rover to be a dog, now an animal named Tweety, but a dog named Rover. And I can do the same thing for cats and canaries as well. So let's do that. So a dog, and then let's do our cat class. So cat is a type of animal. And canary. So Tweety is a canary, and Simba is a cat. Now I get the same display because they're all calling the display method in the parent class. So there's only one display method defined, and it's defined for animals. So all animals display the same, shows the type, the name, and the length. But let's say that animals behave differently in different ways. So for example, one of the things that might be different for these different kinds of animals is what happens when you approach them. So dogs, when you approach them, might wag their tail. And cats, when you approach them, might purr. And birds, when you approach them, or canaries, might chirp. So now, if I change my code, and I run it. A canary named Tweety, you approach Tweety, Tweety chirps. A dog named Rover, you approach Rover, Rover wags his tail. And a cat named Simba, you approach Simba, Simba purrs. So I'm calling the same approach method, but different code is getting run depending on what type of object I'm calling the method on. So these are all animals, but when I approach a canary, I get a chirp. And when I approach a cat, I get a purr. And when I approach a dog, I get a wags his tail. So this is called polymorphism. So polymorphism is when you have many different methods that all have the same name. Poly means many, and morph means shape. So many shapes for the same method name. And the advantage here is that I can just have an array of animals. And this code here doesn't need to know what kind of animal it is. It doesn't have to say, if it's a dog, then do this, else if it's a cat, do this, else if it's a canary, do this other thing. The reason that's a good thing is because it makes it really easy to define new classes. I don't have to change this code at all if I want to add a new class. I can just go ahead and plug a new class in there, like class bear, so not a good thing. And now anytime I have a bear object in my array, this loop doesn't need to change at all. It just automatically does the right thing. A bear named Ben, you approach Ben, Ben mauls you. So polymorphism combined with inheritance makes it really easy to extend the code without having to change everything that's using those classes. Let's just look at the pseudocode to finish this up. So I've added an approach method. So this is going to be a public module approach, and it's going to display under name, comma, wags his tail. So there's my sorry, that was actually the cat definition. I messed that up a little bit. Let me fix that. So this code actually all goes up here in dog, like so. And then the approach method for cats is purrs. And then I'm also going to add an approach method for canaries, chirps, and an approach method, I need the whole class definition for bear. So a bear is a type of animal who mauls you. So that's all the pseudocode. Now you'll notice I don't actually have an approach method for generic animals. So if I just create a generic animal here, like animal a Watsit, if I run this code now, I'm going to get an error. So I get an error that animal object has no attribute approach. So there's a couple of ways to handle this. I can leave this as an error, meaning that you can't create just a generic animal. You have to create a specific kind of animal if you want to run the approach method, because there's really no way to tell what an animal is going to do if you approach it. So this is one way of handling it. Just leave it be an error and then require the programmer to actually call canary, dog, cat, or bear instead of calling animal. Or the other way to handle it is to implement a generic approach method for animals. So what would an animal do if you approach it? Well, maybe it just does something. We don't really know what. And then we'll add the method here as well. So which do you decide to use really depends on the code that you're writing. Just run it one more time. And I misspelled approach. There, so now it works. The animal named Watsit approaches you and does something.